Gary.
I do it once.
Thank you.
I like that rule.
Thank you.
Same order, yes, please.
701, right?
Yes, sir.
701.
We have Mike, Ken, and Don.
Yep, perfect.
Same order, guys? Game on.
I apologize. You're right. I'm wrong.
No, 77.
I am so wrong, Joe. You can kick me in the ass later.
Thank you.
Legitimately, that looks better.
Dark.
Thank you. everybody in here for you guys?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we're all here. You're Robert McKenzie?
Yeah.
Where are you?
I should have been in there.
Thank you.
Top team starting, and their order is
Brennan Travis.
It's gonna go Matt Cornet.
You're welcome.
Living in that thing last night.
Thank you.
I guidebook.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. number 42, John Blood, England, at North. John Blood, England, at York. North 4-2. 4-2, Tony. Thank you.
sorry.
Got it, yeah.
Thank you.
You can charge your phone on it too, though.
Sometimes it's just tough.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. Like, we come out of the qualifier.
Right.
We got the advantage.
I know you can hit a trip 18.
We're playing team. Oh.
Thank you.
I win every time. It's a nice.
I did what Robbie did.
Robbie throws the 30, and you have to throw the 30.
Ladies, you have 5 minutes left to sign up for ladies' level. 5 minutes.
Almost. All right.
have not found a partner for ladies' doubles.
I
Betty?
Yeah, Betty. Worst match we played here.
Yeah.
Welcome to USA Darts production at the Virginia Beach Classic.
All right, Ed, can you hear me?
Vaguely, but yes.
All right, well, I can turn it up a little bit over here. Someone's trying to peek in my curtains.
Yeah, you just sound like...
You got to turn your mic down on your end, or your speaker. Hang on. All right, sorry about that. Someone just came back here.
On my end, Kevin, it sounds like your mic is just a little far away.
Is that a little better?
That is a little better, yes.
All right. Well, just in case everybody's wondering, this is just a test. We're trying something. See if we can get a little commentary from Texas from Ed. I'm up here in Virginia Beach, so we're kind of doing this remotely.
It's a good picture and a good screen you got this weekend, Kevin.
Well, yours is actually a live feed, Ed. You're seeing exactly what I'm seeing. Yeah, well, that could be the internet itself.
Okay. I'll just keep buzzing along and...
We can actually...
watching them dance.
Actually, Ed, you can freeze your video or shut off your camera. That's just one less resource.
Done. And I don't have anything else open up. Here as well.
That should help a little bit with your picture. Can you hear the board okay and everything?
I can.
All right. Well, I think this is working. Turn that down just a little bit. Looks like I lost Facebook. We're still on Ustream, though, or YouTube. Let me restart Facebook.
Right. Sorry, Kevin, making some adjustments here.
Yeah, me too. We're just testing right now anyways.
So on this test, Kevin, I'm not sure what you're seeing on your end. I'm seeing the young lady shoot. Currently, she just hit a trip one and a single 20. I don't know how far behind I may be on you.
No, you're right on.
Okay.
That what you're seeing is what I'm seeing. That's live.
Okay.
So there is no delay between you and me.
Good to know.
That's what we want. Let me see if I can get this Facebook back up. I don't think Facebook likes me streaming to both. Okay, we should be back on Facebook.
Very good. Live from the Virginia Beach Dart Classic with USA Darts Production. We're running a fun test this afternoon to see if we can do some remote commentating. So please bear with us for any interruptions.
Yes, sir. Ed, you're in Texas. I'm up here in Virginia Beach.
Ipsen down here just north of Dallas in Richardson.
Yeah, it would be kind of nice once we get all the bugs worked out of this. Then I can have commentators stay at home.
How's the event been going so far, Kevin?
Actually, it's been pretty good. God, they had 300 and I think it was 330 entries in the luck of the draw Friday night.
Yes, I saw that, 115 teams or something. Yeah. Amazing. I heard it ran really well too. I hear it's one of the best run tournaments. I've only got to go once.
Yeah, it ran really well. I was really surprised how early they got done with that many teams. No real problems. The only problems we really had here this weekend is smoke alarms. You know,
odd darters
at all these events, but this one it was just it's kind of windy here and it's blowing. When they open up the doors, they're blowing this from the smoking area. The smoke's just rushing in, right, and they got a smoke detector right at the door.
That's wise.
Yeah, I know. Well, I don't think they were planning on that to be a smoke area either.
Kevin, just as a heads up, every now and then you freeze on me, so if you don't hear from me for a second, it pops back up pretty quick, but just letting you know.
Is it freezing or the audio?
It just kind of freezes the whole thing, and then I can't hear you for just,
okay.
It's a very short amount of time, but if you notice that, vamp.
Yeah, I haven't noticed you freeze at all.
Okay. So then it's probably just the video, and then I'm not hearing your audio during that, but.
Right.
I will at least try to keep talking and.
You might need some good internet service there in Texas. Well, it says we got, let me refresh this. Let me go back live.
So this is ladies singles that we're currently in?
Yeah, I believe this is going to be ladies singles.
Cricket or 0-1 or combo?
Well, they've been pretty much, the last couple's been 0-1.
Okay.
Okay, looks like we got about 20 viewers right now back on, now that I restarted all this. If anybody's out there and they can hear us, can you please just text in there and let us know? Type something in the comments so we know you can hear us okay?
So, yes, Kevin, I was supposed to be out there this weekend, but life got in the way.
Wait, you were going to come to Virginia Beach?
Yeah.
Now, this is one of my favorite venues.
Oh, yeah. I was going to come out and hang with Tony Smeelin and the guys at Defiance Darts and hang out all weekend with you. And
got a nice little booth set up over there, and he's doing pretty good selling stuff.
Good. I hated to miss it, but
the weather is great. Jesus. I slept with the patio doors open, listened to the ocean and the breeze all night last night. Well, not last night. It was the night before. Last night got a little freaking windy. Is that a little better?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, just turned it up just a little bit.
But this is the busy travel season for myself, so I had to make some executive decisions.
Yeah, it is for me, too. I go right from here to Philadelphia next week.
That's right. That's the CDC event, correct?
Right, the CDC. That's we're going to kick off the CDC next week.
Where are they hosting the CDC event at next weekend?
Philadelphia. It's at the Social Club.
Social Club. Okay.
Yep. It's a nice place. I like it.
My goal is to get to one of those CDC events this year.
Jason, I don't believe they do have a bracket up yet. I don't think they're posting the bracket. I think it's all done here with cards and paper here. So what's new in the radical world, Ed? I don't know if you all know that, but Ed is from Radical Darts.
Not a whole lot. We just got done with the ADA regionals, ramping up for the international event in Spain, followed by the NDA, and then the July ADA Nationals in Memphis.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
Just a busy season. Have a couple new salespeople on board, so we're excited about that.
Cool. Let's get some more boards out. Yeah, I'm looking forward.
Brought a few more darters on board. It's always good.
I'm trying to set it up right now to bring a few players from Michigan with me in to Nationals, so that should be a good time.
You visited the Graceland Hotel, didn't you, when you were there for the regionals?
Yeah, the last time I was there, me and Carl went down there, checked it out. It's actually it's a beautiful place. Had a great
yes,
time
it is.
There.
One thing to note for dart players, though, there's an RV park right across the street.
Yep, already.
That could be that could be an interesting thing for for all of us.
It out right across the street. But this time I'm going to stay in a hotel. I don't, because we're bringing a group of people, so I don't know if we're going to really take the camper this time. I will.
Very good.
I should say I have it with me now. Rhonda said she can't hear me. Can you hear me now, Rhonda? Oh, there's Carl.
I'm not seeing the remarks. Are you on? Is that on the Facebook?
Yeah, it's on the Facebook. If you go to the Facebook, you can see all the comments.
Okay. I was still doing on our call section watching.
Oh yeah, yeah. You can mute the audio on the Facebook so you can see what's going on and stuff, and you don't get any feedback. Carl, say hi. Rhonda, can you hear me now?
Okay, I've got that up now.
Did you get it?
Yep.
Got a couple people saying they still can't hear me.
I can hear you just fine. I'm assuming they can hear me as we just watched the diddle. All right, as we start up, looks like ladies doubles 501.
Carl, you cannot hear me. I gotta shut that off.
I can hear you actually very well now.
Yeah, I know. So can I. I don't like that.
And this is why we test things.
Yep.
Exactly.
Yep. In order for me to hear you, I got to listen to me.
Are they still having troubles hearing you?
Let me try.
Kevin Malinoff and McCamick are attempting to do some remote commentating. This is a test. So please bear with us as we...
Trying some.
Remote. Kevin is in Virginia Beach. I am in Richardson, Texas.
Hang on for a second. Okay, Ed. Obviously, you and me are talking to ourselves. So, let me try. I want to check a couple things. I'm going to disconnect this, and me and you will reconnect here shortly.
Okay, let me know. Right, I'm sitting here watching.
All right, thanks.
You want me to hang up?
Yeah. Oh, I will. Right now. See ya. Testing. Check. Can somebody let me know if you can hear me?